Pina, our first company, was very small. I think we started, maybe we were 8 dancers. Because already she was experimenting with us in all what she wanted to do. So we will be hours in the studio with her doing laughing and crying and running and doing a lot of vocal experiments. She wanted to see what we could all, each one of us could do. And we were all different and young, and we were wild with her. The first real experiment, big work that Pina did was Fritz. Very avant-garde, very different. I had to dance with, actually, I had very tremendous long arms, mechanical arm. Maybe you can see, I don't know. But this was the piece, one of the first pieces performed in Wuppertal. And the public was pretty shocked.
I just fell across my head. Yeah, beautiful stuff.
Well, I was with Pina since 77. Mari was already in the company.
Yes, I was with Pina since 76.
Mine, the first piece I saw was Seven Deadly Sins.
Uh-huh.
And I was like being punched in the stomach, the emotional thing. I'd never seen that in any kind of performance before. And I already had in mind that I want to see that.
Uh-huh. I saw Orpheus, and that was such beautiful dancing. The guys jumped this high off the floor that I thought, this is where I want to dance.
Well, Pina as a dancer, obviously, she has a very unique look, because she has these long, beautiful classical lines. And then she would have these sharp edges, you know, that would sort of kind of pop up, you know, and she would make these bizarre shapes because her body could just do all that. And she loved bending, changing the shape. I don't know, it evolves into not just a human form, but it can be like a creature or something. It gathers its own life.
She had to be moved by their dancing. The women all have to have some kind of beauty. Like sort of the men. I mean, she loves the male beauty as well. And I think even her reasons for putting men in a lot of the drag was for them to experience that feminine beauty. Pina was more about beauty than people realized. Because of that early work being so much about angst, I don't know if the world understood that underlying that was a great sense of beauty, what was beautiful in the world, even through the angst.
Pina always had a collection of books, pieces of paper, figurines. There was one photo that she had, very, very beautiful picture of these three little boys, you know, like nestled together. And it was after their rite of passage, you know, they had just been circumcised or something. It was, you know, she wanted me to do something with it, you know, which is a phrase that would drive you crazy, but she said it often. And so I looked at the photo and I thought, well, okay, there's nothing to do but have me butt naked laying on the rock, you know? So that's what happened.
Pina was a wonderful person, soft-spoken, very patient, and very demanding. And we loved her, but she had one-track mind. What she wanted to do was going to be accomplished, and nobody was going to stop her.
There was some sensibility of tutors that she took with her. This whole idea of dance theater was hers. We never saw anything like that before Pina Bausch Dance Theater. I mean, we really didn't. We thought dance performances were dance performances. That was the end of it. That it could have acting in it, that it could have speech in it, that the set could change, that it could be not just a dance floor, but leaves or water. She let us go out of just pure movement, back to expressionism, a new kind of expressionism. It really, really opened up doors for us all.